Quill's muscles ached, and her eyes grew heavy. She decided it best to set up camp and rest before journeying onto the castle.
Hey, kid. Good. You're alive.
The starling spoke as it circled the campfire. Quill gasped in shock as the starling unveiled monstrous wings and curled horns. It descended, talons gleaming.
Oh dear, I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not scared, Quill replied. I just didn't know starlings were feathered.
This starving thing's gotta go, kid. The name's Adurin. No, we aren't feathered. Only me. I'm working on it. Let's just say, choosing the wrong friends comes with a price. But you seem like a good friend to have. Thanks, I think.
Quill readied her meal and paused to take in the strange winged creature who now called her friend. As a field of stars bloomed over the sky, their campfire conversations deepened.
He's all I have. If I lose him, I don't know what I'll do, confided Quill.
Adurin looked down at his wings.
If I help you find him, can you help me?
If we can,
we will, Starling. I mean, Adurin. Although Quill was far from the safety and comfort of her nook in the cottage, her exhaustion led her into a deep sleep.
Hey, Ghostface. A lot of folks have been waiting for a reader like you to return. I know I have. I'm going to scout the castle up ahead. Keep her safe, okay? For both our sakes.
All right. I'll do what I can.
Durin was nowhere to be found, but looming high on a distant bluff was the castle, a stark reminder of what mattered most. Quill drew a deep breath and readied herself for the journey ahead.
I found another portal. All right. Okay, so there's nothing up there. It's just all here.
Upon their return,
hello, Frog.
It was evident the toad had not warmed to their company.
No really are asking for it. When they fail this second test, Dibs on the runt for dinner.
He muttered to no one in particular. I've heard through my little buds that you've made great strides on your journey. The voice rang from the wood. But the true test of twofold requires mastery from you both.
Oh. Okay. That opens that. So, yes, I know. Running into my microphone here constantly. See, but then I can't get down there. Nope. Yeah, that's what I thought. I don't suppose. Nope, I didn't think so. I feel like I need a second frickin' beetle. Okay, over here. Yes, I know. Problem is, oh, here. I didn't see that wall there. Yeah. Whoa. Doesn't do anything at the moment. Hello. Here we go. Aha, new sword.
The Arcane are enraged by your bond. The stronger it becomes, the harder you'll be to defeat. Reader, through this sword, Quill can channel your energy.
Huh. Okay, what's going on here? I'm trying to... Whoa! Okay. Okay, my stuff is going weird here. Come on. Okay, so I didn't need to bring the beetle over there. go. Brought one down. Oh, I see. Okay, so the question now becomes, I may have screwed myself. Sorry about that. Because I need to be more over here. That opens that, but it still leaves a problem of how do I... Is there... No. How do I get to that door? Oh, you know what? I think I got it. That's fine. There we go. Come on. There we go. And up. Get up there.
Steadfast with this one, Rita. Advise the voice. Things will get difficult. But you mustn't close the book on your hero.
Yes, yes.
Ha
Quill felt more assured, more ready for the dangers of the castle. The toad, however, was not yet impressed.
Still just a rodent in champion's clothes, if you ask me. Doubt they'll find the last portal back here.
Yes, yes. Grouchy old toad. Alright. So that's gonna leave a pretty good spot to go to leave off. We'll go right back through here. And then I believe this is where we're gonna leave off. We'll do a save. Oh, don't need to save. Never mind. All right. Thanks for joining us this time, guys, and we'll see you on the next one.